Hello children, how is it going? I warmly welcome you all to Learn English Language with Sandhana Teacher. Today we are going to learn the third lesson of Unit 6, When We Are Together. Dwe putte adha pigana ganne yanne 6 wana ekake 3 wana paadama. Me ekake meeta kalin paadan deka oyala karala naththam ඒවා ඔයාලට අපේ YouTube channel එකේ grade 8 English language playlist එකට ගියා නම් පහසුවෙන්ම හොයාගන්න පුළුවන්. Right. Today's lesson is based on storytelling. To do this lesson you need your grade 8 pupils book, workbook, a writing book with pens and pencils. Okay, I think we can start now. Children, as our first activity, we are going to do a pupils book activity. So that, take out your pupils book and turn to page number 64. We are going to do activity 6.3. This is the activity. As I said you before, in this activity also you can find out a story. Actually, a story is a sequence of real or fictional events or an account of such sequence. Yam kisi satya ho prabandha kriyadhamayak tamai story ekak kathandrayak kiyala kiyanne. In stories, you can find out an instant called climax. Sama kathawakama climax ekak ehema naththam uchchatama avasthawak api kiyanne koota praaptiyak kiyala. ඒ වගේ අවස්ථාවක් තියෙනවා. ඉතින් දුවේ පුතේ ඔයාලා කතන්දර ලියද්දිත් හැම තිස්සෙම මේ ස්ටෝරි එකට ක්ලයිමැක්ස් එකක් ඇතුළත් කරන්න පුරුදු වෙන්න. Okay. Children, now let's read out this story. Read with me. Hasmal woke up in the morning and looked at the clock. It was 7 o'clock. He jumped out of his bed. Oh no, it's late. He ran to have a shower. He brushed his teeth in no time, washed himself swiftly, and was back in his room within seconds. Oh, look at my shoes. They need to be polished, but I have no time, he said to himself. Hasmal ran out of the house in a hurry. His mother was outside, sweeping the garden. Hasmal, wait! Wait! Why are you running? Mother, I have to go. It's late. I will miss the bus. Wait! Hasmal, don't run! Mother, don't worry, I had my breakfast, said Hasmal and didn't wait for his mother to speak. Next page. When he went to the bus stop, his friends were not to be seen. Oh no, it looks like the school bus has already left. Maybe I can catch the next bus. The bus wasn't crowded as it usually is, Hasmal thought to himself. Within a few minutes, he was in school. He looked around. There was nobody. Where are the students? Where are the prefects who are generally here in the morning? Hasmal was baffled. He thought of going for the morning assembly in the playground. But there is a group of girls playing netball in the playground. Where are the students in our school? Why is it quiet today? Hasmal thought. He thought of going to his classroom to keep his bag. But, oh, it was locked. He tried to open it, but he couldn't. Just then the school security guard was passing by. "Excuse me, why are you in your uniform today?" Well done, children. We read that story very well. Well, now I'm going to discuss this story with you. Look at the beginning sentence of this story. Read the first sentence again. Hasmal woke up in the morning and looked at the clock. Hasmal udeme harila vidyalaya diha baluwa. It was 7 o'clock. Evana vita velawa udasana 7. He jumped out of his bed. Ohu ohuge anden vimata panna. Oh no, it's late. Late. Pramadai. He ran to have a shower. Ohu ran diwa to have a shower. He brushed his teeth in no time. Eyata wedi welawak giye na dat madinna. Washed himself swiftly. Eya wash ekak daagatta swiftly. That means fast, vegayen. And was back in his room within seconds. Tappara kihipayak athulata within seconds eya aayathayage kaamareyata aawa. Seconds kiyanne tatparawalata. Oh, look at my shoes. Balanna mage shoes sapatu diha. They need to be polished. Ewa polish karanna one. But I have no time. Eth mata welawa na. He said to himself. Ohu ohutama kiya gatta. Duwe puthe oyalata me story eka harima pahasuwen therum ganna puluwam. Mama me oyala hamotama pehadiliwama therum ganna puluwam wennai me story ek discuss karanne. නමුත් ඔයාලා මේ ස්ටෝරි එක එකපාරක් කියෙව්වම ඔයාලට ස්ටෝරි එකේ අර්ථය යම් තාක් දුරට වැටහෙන්න ඕනේ. මොකද මේ ස්ටෝරි එකේ වැඩිපුර අමාරු වචන නැහැ. Right. Read the next sentence. Hasmal ran out of the house in a hurry. එයා ගෙදරින් එළියට දෙව්වා in a hurry. කලබලයෙන් නේද? හරිම හදිසියකින්. His mother was outside. එයාගේ අම්මා හිටියේ එළියේ. Sweep in the garden. Gevatta atugamin. Hasmal, wait, where are you running? Hasmal, inna kohedoya duwanne. Ilanda Hasmal kiyenawa, mother, I have to go. Amme, mata yanna wenawa. It's late, mama pramadai. I will miss the bus. Mata bus eka mage herevi. Etakota amma kiyenawa, wait Hasmal, don't run. Inna Hasmal duwanna epa. Etakota Hasmal mokada kiyanne? Mother, don't worry. I had my breakfast. Amme, vada venne pa, mama udde kama gatta. Said Hasmal and didn't wait for his mother to speak. Ya amma katha karana gan hitiye naha neda? Look at the next page. When he went to the bus stop, his friends were not to be seen. Ohu, bus stop ekata giham, bus nawathum palata gihama. His friends were not to be seen. ඔහුගේ යාළුවෝ දකින්න හිටියේ නැහැ. ඉතින් මෙයා මොකද හිතුවේ? Oh no, it looks like the school bus has already left. පේන විදියට බස් එක දැනටම ගිහිල්ලා ඇති කියලා තමයි එයා හිතුවේ. ඊළඟට එයා හිතනවා maybe I can catch the next bus. මට ඊළඟ බස් එක නම් අල්ලගන්න පුළුවන් වේවි කියලා. Right? Read the next sentence too. The bus wasn't crowded as it usually is. Bus එක crowded නැහැ වෙනදා වගේ as it usually is. වෙනදා වගේ crowded කියන්නේ මොකද්ද? Crowd කියන්නේ සෙනඟට. Right? Hasmal thought to himself. Hasmal හිතුවා නේද thought. Thought කියන්නේ think කියන verb එකේ past form එකනේ නේද? Right. Within a few minutes, minutu kīpayakin, he was in school. Ohu paasale. He looked around. Ohu wata pitawa baluwa. There was nobody. Kawruth hitiye naha. Nobody. Kisi kenek hitiye naha. Where are the students? Koheda? Shishya shishyawa lamai neda? Where are the prefects? Koheda? Prefects la shishya nayakayo. Who, kawda? Are generally here in the morning. සාමාන්‍යයෙන් මෙතන උදේට ඉන්න. Hasmal was baffled. Yeah, baffled උනත්. Baffled means to feel publicly disgraced or confused. ඔහු වියවුලට පත් වුණා. He thought of going for the morning assembly in the playground. එයා හිතුවා morning assembly එකට යන්න ඕනේ කියලා playground එකේ තියෙන. Morning assembly කියන්නේ මොකක්ද ඔයාලා දන්නව නේද? උදෑසන රැස්වීම. Right. Read the next sentence too. But there's a group of girls playing netball in the playground. Playground එකේ හිටියේ assembly එක නෙමෙයි කවුද හිටියේ? Group of girls ගෑනු ළමයි කණ්ඩායමක් playing netball. Netball සෙල්ලම් කරමින්. Where are the students in our school? අපේ ස්කෝලේ ළමයි කොහෙද? Why is it quiet today? අයද හරිම quiet. Quiet කියන්නේ නිශ්ශබ්ද කියන එක. Right. Hasmal thought. He thought of going to his classroom. ඔහු හිතුවා ඔහුගේ පන්ති කාමරයට යන්න to keep his bag. ඔහුගේ බෑග් එක තියන්න. But oh, it was locked. එක lock කරලා වහලා. He tried to open it. ඔහු උත්සාහ කරා එක open කරන්න, අරින්න. But he couldn't. Could not. ඔහුට බැරි වුණා. Just then the school security guard was passing by. එතනින් කවුද ගියේ? ඉස්කෝලේ security guard. මුරකරු නේද? Security කියන්නේ මොකද දුවේ පුතේ? Yes, that means safety. Who is the guard? Yes, a guard is a person who protects or watch over something or someone. Right? Then he said that, excuse me, why are you in your uniform today? Then security guard ahanawa, excuse me, why are you in your uniform today? Ayyada nila endumen ævilla inne. Duwe putte den oyalata me kathandaraya pahadiliida. What has happened to Hasmal? Yes, definitely it's a holiday. He has gone to school on a holiday. Right. Now let's look at the given questions in this activity. Okay, children, they have given us 5 questions. Now you can write down your answers for these questions. After that, play the video to check your answers. දුවේ පුතේ මෙතනදී 5 වෙනි ප්‍රශ්නය තියෙන්නේ. Give a suitable ending to the story. මේ කතාන්දරයට ගැළපෙන අවසානයක් ලියන්න කියලා. මේ කතාන්දරය මෙතනදී අවසන් වුණ නෑනේ. ඉතින් දුවේ පුතේ ඔයාලට පුළුවන් ඔයාලා කැමති විදිහට මේ ස්ටෝරි එකට ending එකක් ලියන්න. Right. ඔයාලා උත්තර ලියලා වීඩියෝ එක play කරන්න. අපි ඔයාලාගේ උත්තර සාකච්ඡා කරමු. Finished. Okay, let's discuss your answers. The first question was, what time did Hasmal wake up? Duwe putte metana tiyana wake up kiyana wacanaya saha oyala ahalathi get up kiyana wacanayat. Mokadda me wacana deke tiyana wenasa? Wake up and get up. Children, listen to this sentence. I woke up at 5 a.m. but I got up at 5:30 a.m. Listen to that sentence again. I woke up at 5 a.m. but I got up at 5:30 a.m. දුවේ පුතේ මෙතනදී woke up ඇහැරුණා කියන්නේ එයා නිින්දෙන් ඇහැරුණා කියන අර්ථය. Got up කියන්නේ get up කියන verb එකේ past අවස්ථාවනේ නේද? ඒ කියන්නේ යා and then බිමට බැස්සා කියන අදහස, නැගිට්ටා කියන අදහස. Right? So wake up and get up are two different words. They have two different meanings. මෙතන මේ ප්‍රශ්නේදී අහන්නේ What time did Hasmal wake up? Hasmal ne kitte kumana velave deeda kiyala. Yes. What's your answer? Yes. That is at 7 o'clock. At 7 o'clock. මේ ක්වෙස්චන් එකට උත්තරය හරිම පහසුවෙන් ස්ටෝරි එකේ දෙවෙනි සෙන්ටෙන්ස් එකෙන් ඔයාලට ලබා ගන්න පුළුවන්. Right. Now read the second question. What did he do after he woke up? What මොකක්ද did he do ඔහු කළේ after he woke up? ඔහු ඇහැරුණාට පසුව. Immediately after he woke up, what did he do? Yes, he looked at the clock. Ohu,
orolosuwa diha, bitti orolosuwa diha baluwa. Me prashneyata oyalata me pilithura liyanna puluwan, ehema naththam samahara vita oyala liyala athi. He jumped out of his bed and he had a shower, he brushed his teeth and he got ready to go to school.
Me wage uttarayak liyala thiyenawa nam, oyalage pilithura yam thak durakata niweradi. All right. Read the third question. What was unusual about this day? Me davase unusual. Asamanya de kumakda. Yes. The correct answer is the bus was not crowded.
Ya school te yanna hadaddi yalata visheshayenma asamanya lesa darune bus eka crowded nathi eka neida? E gana
හැට පස්වන පිටුවේ මෙන්න මෙහෙම සඳහන් වෙනවා the bus wasn't crowded as it usually is. ඒ සෙන්ටෙන්ස් එකේම usually කියන වර්ඩ් එක තියෙනවානේ. ඒ නිසා අසාමාන්‍ය දේ ලෙස අපිට ගන්න පුළුවන් bus එකේ සෙනඟ නොමැති වීම. The bus was not crowded is the correct answer for this question. Question number 4. What would have happened if he had talked to his mother in the morning? ඔහුගේ මවට උදේ කතා කළා නම් what would have happened? කුමක් සිදු වෙන්න තිබ්බද? එයා එයාගේ අම්මට උදේ පාන්දර කතා කරලා ආවා නම් අම්මා කියන්න තිබ්බා එයා පාසලට යන ලෑස්තිලා තියෙන නිවාඩු දවසේ කියලා නේද? So අපිට කියන්න පුළුවන් මෙන්න මේ වගේ උත්තරයක්. He could understand that it was a holiday. He could understand that it was a holiday. Eda nivada dinayak kiyala huta therum ganna thibba. This is the last question. Give a suitable ending to the story. Story ekata suitable galapena ending ekak avasanayak dakwanna kiyala kiyana. Itin duwe putte wala lassana avasanayan me story ekata liyala athi. මතකෙතුව ඔයාලා ලියලා තියෙන ස්ටෝරි එකේ එන්ඩින් එක මේ වීඩියෝ එකේ කමෙන්ට් සෙක්ෂන් එකට ටයිප් කරන්න. එතකොට මට පුළුවන් ඔයාලගේ වැරදි අඩුපාඩු තියෙනවා නම් ඔයාලගේ රයිටින් පීස් එකේ සකස් කරලා දෙන්න. Right. Now I'm going to give you two example endings to this story which were written by two of my students in my class. Right. The first ending is this.
කතාව අන්තිමේද නැවතුනේ security guard අහනවානේ අයියා uniform එකකින් ඉස්කෝලට ආවේ කියලා. එතකොට හස්මාල් කියනවා
I come to school in uniform every day. Why do you ask? Hasmal replied. But today is a holiday, said the security officer. Then Hasmal realized what had happened.
මේ එක උත්තරයක් මේ උත්තරයත් බලන්න.
Oh no! Hasmal understood what had happened. He felt embarrassed. The security guard made a phone call to his mother. She was standing in front of the gate. Hasmal went home with his mother without saying anything. Okay children, now let's move to our next activity. Now take out your workbook and turn to page number 47. Let's do activity 3. This is the activity.
Read the question. Study the pictures below and match them with the phrases given on page 48. මේ දීලා තියෙන පින්තූර අධ්‍යයනය කරලා ඒව ගලපන්න කියනවා ඊළඟ පේජ් එකේ දීලා තියෙන මෙන්න මේ phrases එක. Beforehand, let's read these phrases. Read with me. Five rabbits were playing, started running, told him what they heard, went to the play area, heard a big noise, met a big bear, bear suggested to see what happened, saw a fallen branch. Okay, children. Now, try to match these phrases with the given pictures. After that, let's discuss your answers. Okay, children, now let's discuss your answers. This is the first picture. In this picture, you can see a bear, and as we can see, he is thinking of something, something about a tree, and as we can see, a fruit of that tree is falling down. Okay, what is the phrase that matches with this picture? Yes, that is this. Bear suggested to see what happened. Bear suggested to see what happened. ඔයාලගේ පිළිතුරු මේ ගමන්ම ටික් කරගන්න. Right. Look at the next picture. This is the second one. In this picture, you can see five rabbits. And look at their ears. So, what is the matching phrase? Yes, that is. Heard a big noise. Vishala shabdayak ehuna. E nisa neda yala kan digu karagena inne. Right. Next picture is this. The rabbits are running. So, the suitable phrase is this. Started running. Look at the fourth picture. In this picture, you can see the bear and a rabbit. Told him what they heard. Told him what they heard. ඔහුට කිව්වා ඔවුන්ට ඇහුණ දේ. This is the last picture given in this activity. Yes, some rabbits are playing. So the correct phrase is five rabbits were playing. Five rabbits were playing. Okay, children, now let's do the second part of this activity. Read the question. Now complete this story with the above phrases. ඉහත දක්වනලද phrases භාවිත කරලා මේ කතන්දරය සම්පූර්ණ කරන්න කියලා කියනවා. There are 9 blanks in this story. And the first answer is given, that is, 5 rabbits were playing. So that we can cut off the first answer. Okay, children, now write your answers to complete the story. After that, play the video. Let's check your answers. Completed the story? All right, let's check your answers. Pay attention, everybody. I am reading the story with correct answers. One day, five rabbits were playing under a tree. දවසක් හාව පස් දෙනෙක් ගසක් යට සෙල්ලම් කරමින් සිටියා. They heard a big noise. ඔවුන්ට ඇසුණා විශාල ශබ්දයක්. They did not know what it was. ඔවුන් දැනගෙන හිටියේ නැහැ එය කුමක්ද කියලා. They looked up. ඔවුන් ඉහළ බැලුවා. and saw the vast sky above. ඔවුන් දැක්කා ඉහළින් තියෙන විශාල අහස. The rabbit started trembling. ඔවුන් වෙව්ලන්න පටන් ගත්තා. Trembling means shaking. They said, "Oun kiwa, the sky is falling." Ahasa kadang vetna kiyala. And then started running. In pasuwa duwanna patan gatta. On the way, they met a big bear. E athara maga ounta hamuna vishala walasek. Why are you running? Ayyala duwanne. Asked the big bear. Vishala walasa huwa. The rabbits told him what they heard. Havo kiwa ounta asuna de. And they were going to inform the king. E wageema oun yanne rajithumata denum denna kiyala. I know the king's palace. Mama dannawa rajithumage maligaya. The bear said. Walasa kiwa. But before namuth ita kalin that I should also go back to where you were before. මම යන්න ඕනේ ඔයාලා කලින් හිටපු තැනට. The bear suggested to see what happened. බෙයා යෝජනා කළා මොකද වුනේ කියලා සොයලා බලන්න. Then the rabbits and the bear went to the play area. හාව සහ බෙයා play area එකට සෙල්ලම් කර කර හිටපු ස්ථානයට ගියා to see what happened. කුමක්ද සිදු වුනේ කියලා බලන්න. The bear saw a fallen branch. බෙයා දැක්ක වැටුණ අත්තක් and laughed loudly. හයියෙන් hina una. Laughed කියන්නේ සිනහසුනා කියන එක. Loudly හයියෙන්. Branch කියන්නේ ගසක අත්තකට. Then he said, ඔහු කියනවා, "You timid rabbits." Timid කියන්නේ වියගුළු කියන අදහස. It's not any sky. ඒ අහසක් නෙවෙයි. It is only a branch. ඒ ගහක අත්තක් විතරයි. Now go and play. දැන් ගිහිල්ලා සෙල්ලම් කරන්න කියලා තමයි වලහා කිව්වේ. ඉතින් දුවේ පුතේ මේ ස්ටෝරි එක හරි එහෙම නැත්නම් මේ වගේ වෙනත් ස්ටෝරි එකක් හරි ඔයාලා ඔයාලගේ මව් භාෂාවෙන් අහලා ඇද්දි ඉතින් මේ ස්ටෝරි එක ඔයාලට ෆැමිලිය පහසුවෙන්ම උත්තර ලියලා ඇති කියලාත් මම හිතනවා. So now you can put your marks out of 13 in your writing book. As well, you can put it in the comment section of this video. I think you really enjoyed this lesson. Now let's see your homework activity. Write a story you know in your writing book. Duwe putte oyala homework ekak vidihata oyala danna kathawak oyalage writing book eke liyanna. Matakathuwa kathawak liyaddi eya atheethaye sidu deyak nisa past tense bhavitha karanna. අතීත කාල ක්‍රියාපද භාවිත කරන්න. Okay children, today we read two stories. And as your homework activity I ask you to write a story too. Of course if you like this video, don't forget to click the like button of this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. You can check out our other lessons by clicking the grade 8 English language playlist. See you soon with the next lesson. Till then, take care. Goodbye, children. I am Sabri teacher.